Much efforts at understanding economic fluctuations in recent decades have relied on frameworks that assume that all households are identical. The assumption of identical households may not be innocuous when it comes to understanding economic fluctuations and their interaction with macroeconomic policies. So this has given rise to a new class of models, so-called HANC models, which stands for Heterogeneous Agent New Keynesian Models, which combine elements of traditional New Keynesian models, namely frictions in goods and labor markets, with elements that incorporate heterogeneity across households. For example, the presence of idiosyncratic shocks that hit different households in different ways over time, differential access to financial markets, or the fact that some households may be subject to borrowing constraints while others are not. So this new class of models allows one to address a number of questions that could not be tackled in the context of the more traditional models. For instance, what is the role of inequality in determining the impact of aggregate shocks on the economy? Or what are the effects of monetary and fiscal interventions on inequality? Or even, what is the role of inequality in the design of optimal monetary and fiscal policies? A drawback with this new class of HANC models is that they are complex models. So in particular, they cannot be solved with pencil and paper. They need to be solved with numerical methods and the use of a computer. As a result, they are a bit of a black box. One cannot get an easy intuition for some of the findings, and they are difficult to teach in the classroom, and some of those findings are hard to be conveyed to policymakers. In my research, mostly in collaboration with my colleague Davide De Bortoli, we are trying to explore whether simpler, analytically tractable models can be good approximations to these complex HANC models. In particular, we want to understand what is the role played by the idiosyncratic income shocks, the role played by the presence of borrowing constraints, and the role played by different degrees of liquidity of different assets, which are often assumed and combined in these complex HANC models. In current work, we are trying to understand whether a simple model that we call TANC, which stands for two-agent New Keynesian model, may be a good approximation of the properties of these richer HANC models. So in a TANC model, there are two types of agents. One type has full access to financial markets, and the second type has no access to financial markets whatsoever, so they cannot smooth consumption by borrowing and lending. This is very much a work in progress, and we look forward to being able to report some exciting findings using this framework.